Behold, human beings living in an underground den. Here, they have been from their childhood and have their legs and necks chained so that they cannot move and can only see before them, being prevented by the chains from turning round their heads. Above and behind them, a fire is blazing at a distance. And between the fire and the prisoners, there is a raised way. And you will see, if you look, a low wall built along the way. Men pass along the wall carrying all sorts of vessels and statues and figures of animals made of wood and stone which appear over the wall. Some of them are talking, others silent, and they see only their own shadows or the shadows of one another, which the fire throws on the opposite wall of the cave. How could they see anything but the shadows if they were never allowed to move their heads? To them, the truth would be literally nothing but the shadows of the images. That is certain.
Thank you. What a shame. Well, now, with just over a minute left, the replay on Tuesday looks absolutely vital, and there's Archimedes. And I think he's had an idea.
Eureka!
Archimedes out to Socrates. Socrates back to Archimedes. Archimedes out to Heraclitus. He beats Hegel. Heraclitus, a little flick. Here he comes on the far post. Socrates is there. Socrates headed in. Socrates has scored. The Greeks are going mad. Socrates scores. The beautiful cross from Archimedes. The Germans are disputing it. Hegel is arguing that the reality is merely an a priori adjunct of non-naturalistic ethics. Kant, by the categorical imperative, is holding that ontologically exists only in the imagination. And Marx is claiming it was offside. But Confucius has answered them with a final whistle. It's all over. Germany, having trounced England's famous midfield trio of Bentham, Locke and Hobbs in the semi-final, have been beaten by the odd goal. And let's see it again. There it is. Socrates heads in, and Leibniz doesn't have a chance. And just look at those delighted Greeks. There they are, Chopper Sophocles, Empedocles of Acragas. What a game he had. And Epicurus is there, and Socrates, the captain, who scored what was probably the most important goal of his career.
Push it!
You come push it. Push it real good.